But yeah, default combat speed's a nightmare. Absolute nightmare. Bullet stones, we have spike stones. See, I don't know, that overseer didn't leave a key. Must have been 30 or 40. It was there's a way. It was. We'll get there. Oh, it doesn't actually tell us? Or is it this one? Here we go. That was only 15 rounds. Oh, it reset partway through. Yeah, fair. I don't know how far up this goes. No, this is just the last combat in here. Yeah. Yeah, real bad. And then we have a door here that... You would think that there would be a key on one of these dudes out here guarding it, but there is not, because wizardry, unless it dropped, which it does not look like it did. No. Alright, which means we get the quick save.
Lock tight.
And force the door.
Prepared.
Oh, well, that was easy. Ha ha!
Nothing I hear.
Magic nectar. Good get. Let me guess, it's gonna be locked. I would have never guessed.
Bullshit.
Holy shit, Chunk actually picked a lock. He does exist. Who are you?
You. Wait, I know you. From Guardia. Lost Guardia. Do you remember? So much has happened since then. After you left, the Higadi came for us as promised. We returned to Dominus to fulfill our great destiny and to reclaim the stolen astral domine. Came so close. So close. The Dark Savant shot our ship down. I am the only survivor, though I am not long in this life. I will not ascend to the cosmic circle. But you might, if the Savant can't be stopped.
Oh shit, she was a Helizoid, one of those, the blonde girls that rode around on the space scooters. All right. So what's this pendant then? 10 to Eagle Eye and 50% fire resistance. That's pretty good. I don't know what Eagle Eye does. Eagle Eye. Successfully hit and penetrate a creature with a ranged weapon. Huh. All right. Scales off of senses, which I think he would eventually get anyways, because senses, well, long ways away, but senses is one of his better skills. He's actually nearing a level two by the look of things. And we also got their banner. Long live the Helizoid. Well, not in this case. All right.
Found.
What else you got? Well, that looks like a musical instrument. We'll be with you momentarily, Rhino Man. There's interesting loot to get first. We did everything we could. Forget the clusterfuck of ass that was Wizardry 7. I believe you mean to say the best RPG ever made, Ela. You keep Wizardry 7's name out of your goddamn mouth. Ooh, mantis gloves. And a violin. Oh, this is probably her crap. And a mystic spear. And an empty bottle. All right, what do we got? It's been a while since we've had any interesting gear drop. Literally mantis gloves, plus 14 AC, holy hell, and plus 5 dex on top of it. I mean, these are going to swell,
to the mostly because the spoils.
Mostly because he's the only one in the party that can use them, but there you go, nice. And the spear 8 to 24, that's actually the spear that the ninja is using. I think he's... Swell can use it here. Swell, you can have one as well. I don't think he'll switch, though, because he has the cursed sword in his main hand. I would happy to be wrong about that, though. Strings of Seduction. Ooh, Turncoat. I think I would rather freeze, admittedly. But I think I would rather that than slow. All right, so I mean, that was actually some gear. Those were three things that are actually going to get used. We all know Ultima 7 is the best RPG ever made. All that important leveling you have to do, in-depth combat.
Nothing found.
Oh God. Your RPG senses were so satisfied by the 50th time the avatar said name job bye to some NPC. Oh boy. Eel's gonna be getting death threats again.
Locked.
Come on, Chunk. You did it once. I need you to do it again, buddy. Chunk, quit fucking around. God damn it, Chunk. Frostmourne hungers. Jesus Christ, Ela. You can't call it Frostmourne for legal reasons. You gotta call it something else, like Icy Sad. Come on now. You know how it goes. Lizard's almost as bad as Wizards of the Coast. They'll send the Pinkertons at you. Oh my god, doors. Okay. Hello.
Well, it's about time, Private.
I hate you already.
Do you know how long I've been here? Do you know what I've been through? I'll tell you. The most poorly planned mission in the history of the IUF, that's what. I swear, Ymir's horn is starting to penetrate his brain. I don't know what he was thinking. He sends us out here, and we get chomped half to pieces by some giant sea thing, and that's not the half of it. Then I get held hostage by these deranged, murderous, fin-loving creatures. Do you think I can count on some IUF support? Hell no! Damn it, I know you're here, but it took you too damn long. Ymir should have sent you sooner. Escort me back to Mount Gygas, soldiers. That's an order!
I don't wanna. I think I wanna stab you in the head and leave you here for dead.
Good riddance.
Oh no.
Goodbye.
I know what I have to do, but I don't know if I have the strength to do it. Yeah, shut the fuck up. Yeah, continue to shut the fuck up. Can I steal any of your shit? Bet your ass I can. What you got? A musket. It sucks. A leather cuirass, a war blade, boots, and leather greaves. I'm taking your fucking dog tags too, because you're a prick. Alright.
Yes?
So, we're actually moving Goldleaf's portal from Arnica to here, because it's easier to get from Umpani base to Arnica than it is to get here from Umpani base. There you go. New item for Cudcrawler. Icy Sad.
Well, Private, I do owe you my thanks. I thought I'd never see this place again. You've done the IUF proud.
No, it's the general shit.
Now, if you'll just escort me to General Ymir, so I can get my hands on that puffed up bag of crap, General my butt.
Yeah, we're gonna nap first. Yeah, the Trang are the more interesting of the factions in this, and I honestly, if they weren't creepy spider slug things, I would probably ally with them, because their solution to all of this is much more pragmatic, and I think the more, I wouldn't necessarily say sensible of the two faction paths, but they seem like they're thinking, whereas these guys are just rah-rah military who, Bart explosions, Rhino men. Dude's pretty thick, though. Ready. What level is he? He's only level 11, and he's got more health than us because he has a vitality of 100. That'll do it.
Yes?
I feel much better.
It's weird having a seventh character in the party. It doesn't feel right. I'm used to only seeing six sets of bars. And having the seventh one up there is fucking with me. Oh my god. Get in the elevator.
Please present secure. Access verified.
Yay, another quick save. I think this is a straight shot. Yes. They should court-martial him and have him tried for treason and then turn him into meat steaks. Like the Thorn Demons from Dungeon Master 2. The best Dungeon Master game. And now I wait. I know Elo's there, and I know he's listening. And he's just mad that Dungeon Master 2 is better than the first one. Get out of the way, fuck! Jesus Christ, alright.
Soldiers! General Yamir, I have a few words for you! Everything I had been through could have been prevented if they had listened to your orders, sir. It's good to be back, General. And I don't want to hear anything out of you, Private. Got it? Just shut your mouth.
Glomf. I can't believe it. Why, we giving you up for lost. I must say, soldiers, you have the eternal thanks of the IUF for getting my boy back home. You look tired, Glomf. Why don't you get yourself some rest before we debrief?
300,000 XP, all right.
Soldiers, I owe you my thanks. You got me back here alive. Something those other no good... other unfortunate soldiers who lost their lives could not do. I'm gonna take some much-needed R&R. I'll see you around.
I think you can actually recruit him. And another 100,000 XP. Jeez.
I can't make this too clear. This is the mission of all missions. You're going straight into the Trang nest at Martin's Bluff, and this mission is super confidential. Now listen up. The Trang are gaining ground on his troops. I hate to say it, but it's true. I need you to do something about that. The reason they're gaining ground on us is an issue of pure manpower. For every new recruit we get, they're breeding 20. We know the breeding happens on their ship, the Narguset. We've got to stop that breeding, or, well, I don't even like to think about it. Here's the problem. We can't destroy the ship. Damn thing's cloaked. But maybe we can hit them where they land. They've got some kind of transporter, and if we can shut it down, we got a chance. They'll be stuck on that damn ship, which is just fine by me. Recon's had some trouble getting through security over there, but I think this EMP might get you in. Go find that transporter, troops. We've got to.
Okay. I mean, I guess we're nearing. We're actually, at this point, we're quite far into the game. I'd say we're probably like, I don't know, 70% through the game, maybe more than that. We are nearing the worst part of this game.
For you.
We're a little ways away. But it's gonna get far worse before we're done.
Bye.
Wow, four levels. That's pretty good. Alright, Swell. Maxed out his strength, finally! Power strike. It gets worse. Oh my good god, yes. Just you wait. Just wait until we get to the Repax base. It's terrible. Absolutely terrible. You wanna, here, have rest all, Swell. Have silence, and have... I'm gonna give you cure paralysis, too. Alright, what do you need? Water and air. Water he has, air he has. Power strike! You have selected power drive. And we'll give you some divine. Hila, you're never gonna get better, but we'll try. Oh, you've maxed out your dex. You've gotten the expert skill reflection. Reflection? It makes you a quick boy. All right, let's give you just all of the air spells. There you go. You're eventually gonna be casting something out of there, maybe one day, hopefully. So what does reflection do? Increases a character's armor class by allowing them to move so fast that a double image is created. Hila is now his own mirror images with a skill of 3. Oh boy, how's his AC looking? I bet you it's so high. Wow, 11. That's pretty crazy. That's nuts. He's now on par with Chunk, who's running around in pajamas. Your magnesium powder came. Jesus Christ. Your knees ain't what they used to be, but boy, you're trying. I don't. God damn it, Hila. Sin has run out of things for me to put skill points into. I guess it's just gonna be artifacts and pointed daggers and dual weapons. Rove, are you going to be a good boy and give me nuclear blast? God damn it, Rove. I see no nuclear blast. I'm gonna take fucking Firestorm, though. I've heard people say that Shadowhound's actually worth casting, because when you get ambushed in your sleep, it, like, wakes you up. But, eh. I get Knock Knock for picking locks. Sure. Okay, what is Knock Knock? Knock Knock is Earth. His skill of 15. He is a mighty Earth wizard. Said no one ever. Okay. What does he want us to do? I wasn't really paying attention. I know he said something about the Trang. Find the Trang transporter, disable it, and destroy their ship. Okay, so of course, naturally, we have to go back to Arnica. So we can't use her teleport.
Yes?
I can use the one in here, though. Which is actually right up here.
Nothing found.
Asleep. I know what's coming. Realistically, if we make good progress, which honestly, I think we've actually been making really good progress in this game so far, because we're what, 6 streams in? 7 streams? We're not even at the 40-hour mark.
I saw something moving.
And
over there.
People, if you go into like how long to beat, this the average for this game is like 90 hours or some fuck stupid thing. So I think we're making really good progress. It's just, it's going to get so much worse. I'm gonna walk at you guys in a menacing fashion in just a moment. 98. Yeah, that's actually a fair point. That, yeah, we are using the combat speed up, and that probably is substantially affecting playtime. I hate this game. We're gonna hang back, but if you try to move, we're gonna get your grill! Upside, though, is that we're high enough level that, like, these things being top-end enemies for this area are a complete non-threat to everyone except Rove.
Not even close.
Great!
Suddenly,
I am afflicted.
I have suffered an injury.
Literally
a corpse.
Take this.
I am much better.
The illness be gone.
Let's.
I'm on
heal.
It.
Much better.
Take this.
You see how we've done?
I'm on it.
I don't feel so good.
Wedge the melees murder. Between these things.
I have suffered an injury.
Oh, you're fine. Being
I'm
a baby.
On it.
Fucking Rove.
Take this. Take this.
Measure our progress in bodies.
Okay.
My illness be.
Yes.
Trying to remember how we actually got to the Trang. I think it was through the Trini area? Is it the south, maybe? Oh. I don't know. Let's find out. Hey, bat.
Look, it's alive.
It is the cell.
To victory.
Okay, thank you. This is just so fucking painful. Like, I just want to fucking not fight trash mobs and deal with this horseshit. But the game is like, no, you get 9 twilight bats after you just killed a bunch of stupid weed things. Guess it's right here.
Taken care of.
Now I'm gonna wait. And through the swamp. Okay, yep. Yep.
Oh,
Taken care of.
With pleasure.
I'm on it.
Out your after. Much better.
Taken care of.
I'm not even going to bother with those other three bats. I do not care.
Yes.
I'm on it.
The hordes keep coming,
Jack.
I feel much.
Oh my god, we've literally run from one random encounter into another. This is terrible.
Is all this blood mine?
I'm on it.
Ah,
better. I have suffered an injury.
With pleasure. Segundas.
Great.
Take this. Take this.
Aye.
Just let me run. Let me run.
Much better.
Check.
Could you imagine doing this without the combat speed up on? My god.
My illness be gone.
I have no words. If this had playtesters, I'm honestly curious. I would be curious to read playtesting reports for this game, because I bet there's just, oh man. Imagine playing Wizardry 8 in general. I know, and I'm not even charging anyone for it. It's the worst.
That's an improvement.
Back to normal again.
Perfect. My status rises.
8 bucks.
Let's show the enemy who's in charge.
I've got a scratch or two.
Just immediately opens up combat with a casual 97 damage, and Goldleaf gained a level. What? But thank you, Pineapple. I appreciate it every little bit. All right, they want to play with elementals. We'll play with elementals then.
Taken care of.
I bet mine are bigger.
With pleasure.
Doesn't seem worth it at 75 on sale. Sizes and everything, that's very true, but when it comes to elementals, it often is. But yeah, I don't know, like, it depends on what you're looking for. The early game in this is fine, it's just, you have to know what you're getting into. The vanilla game, I wouldn't recommend to anyone.
Ow.
Take this.
Look, there's theirs. With its 420 hit points, nice. I don't know where they are. It looks like they're way over there. I don't really care about their elemental, honestly. I'm more curious about them. Because they're spamming fucking crush on us. And unlike our spells, it actually works. Where are we? Aha.
Yes.
Oh. One damage. 102 damage. You just die.
That is a me too.
Everybody in this party, just a crush is just going to kill us. Much health do these fuck? And they have 160 hit points. Game design. How does it work? How do you balance encounters in your RPG? Sirtek? No idea at the end. I will, however, level Gold Leaf because I like spells. Anything good? No, not really. I'm actually gonna get Silence for Gold Leaf too. That might be useful against bullshit spam. Iron Will and... is it Earth Magic or is it Water? Water. More stamina related chicanery.
Nothing to hear.
Perfect.
Okay.
My status rises.
And of course they're in the center of the road, so it's not like I can avoid them. Because that would make sense.
With pleasure. With pleasure.
No effect. Reloading.
Come on, you wee beasties. Let's fight.
Taken care of.
No, I'm gonna reload. I'm gonna reload and we'll get buffed
yes?
up.
Yes?
Yes. Darn it.
Okay, we're a little closer this time, so I'm gonna try and
yes.
run, and ideally we'll be able to get right in their grill. Oh, Gold Leaf's probably dead. Somehow survives. I'll take it. Fuck you, Earth Elemental. Alright, hello. Let's go ahead and try freezing you assholes. What are they? Oh no, their resistances are on the low end, 70. Good God. Here are these things that can just spam like half your party's hit points with a spell. They have more hit points than your thickest fighter. And they're resistant to all of your everything. Big arrow now.
Great.
Are you the paralyzed one? No, actually. Alright, I'm actually pleased that they killed her first. Because the other one should comparatively fall pretty
I'm on
readily.
It.
I'm gonna try to move here. Hope that he doesn't attack me, but of course he does.
Well, all men are mortal.
Yeah, this game has some issues, some of which I think are pretty fundamentally just completely fucked.
Yes. Great.
And encounter balance is up there. Real up there. Alright, so you've got... Why is there so thick? I don't think my Earth Elementals are that thick. I need thicker elementals. Oh, this one does hit as hard as mine do, so that's something at least. 118, good God.
Yes.
All right. Where's my powder? Where is it? use this there. Quick save.
What now?
I didn't even see how much XP that was.
I feel much better.
25,000. I think I would rather fight the hell ghosts. Okay. Yes. Yeah, resurrection isn't a big deal, thankfully. The only downside is that you like lose experience points, but we're to the point now where leveling takes so many that it doesn't matter.
I feel much better.
Yes?
Okay.
Very well.
It's good to-
I am here for your powder. Give it to me. Spells you got? Anything worth anything? Looks like just the same crap you had last time. Book of Removal. I'll remove curse. Then magic screen. Bleh.
I hope to.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Well, let's sleep.
See
the Rapax real quick. Rapax, however it's pronounced.
You've returned.
I think we probably have some garbage to vendor.
All set.
Yes?
Dragon, oh, that's old. We can sell the scuba gear. We'll sell the extra one.
Yes?
I guess.
What now?
And now it's all the garbage I just have sitting in my inventory. Blew 18,000 gold on powder and came out with more money in the end. Instead, you need to Shanghai DW Bradley, have him do an interview with you on what he smoked during Wizardry 7. Oh my god. I don't know that he has been involved in anything since... I think it was Wizards and Warriors. I think that was the last he's had his name in any game credits. That or Dungeon Lords, whichever one came most recently. I think it was Wizards and Warriors. So I don't know if he's in self-imposed exile or just decided to call it quits. But man, an interview with him. I don't think I would be able to approach it objectively. Because on one side, I think he has some good gameplay ideas. But on the other side, I think he's a fucking nut job who needed people to rein him in more than they ought, than they did, I should say. He's kind of like, God, what's his name? Peter Molyneux. You know, he did crazy cool stuff when he was at Bullfrog because he wasn't in charge. And I think that's what DW Bradley needs, is give him, you know, pick his brain for stuff, but don't let him run everything or he's just gonna ruin it.
Yes.
Yes.
Dungeon Lords was his last credit? Okay, yeah. Bad when the idea is guy's also the guy who controls everything. Exactly. Like, D.W. Bradley has some good ideas. There are aspects of his games, and you can tell that they're his ideas because they're in all of the games that he's worked on. Like the multi-classing. The multi-classing from Wizardry 6, Wizardry 7, it's the same multi-classing that you have in Wizardry or Wizards and Warriors. They kind of had it in Dungeon Lords. Dungeon Lords is just kind of a weird character progression system. But you can tell he had his hand in it. And so, like, he has good ideas. It's just he needs somebody to be like, no, you need to kind of rein this in for this reason, and so on and so forth. And somehow, like you said, yeah, he got control over everything. And Wizardry 6 wasn't bad. There was some fart sniffing there. Some pretty intense fart sniffing, but it was kind of taking a back seat. Wizardry 7 was when it went off the rails. And this feels like somebody took a corpse of one of his games and reanimated it into its own thing. Like, the bones are familiar, but the game itself is not. It's just not the same. So, it's kind of like a good comparison would be when Ubisoft remade Might and Magic. They made Might and Magic 10. How you could tell what they were going for, but they just didn't. They just didn't do it as good as it had been done previously, or they missed some key things. Just like Disney's Star Wars. Oh man, don't bring that evil into chat. I stopped with new Star Wars. I saw episode 7, and it was bad enough.
Burning to kill.
I'm not fighting this. It was bad enough that outside of the first season of The Mandalorian, I have not seen any new Star Wars. I take that back. I've seen Rogue One. Rogue One was actually legit good. I can't shit on that one.
Nothing found.
But that's about all that I've consumed, and it was just that I felt was worth it. Season 1 of Mandalorian was pretty good. I enjoyed it, but yeah, it's not what it once was, and I don't think it was worth what was sacrificed to get it. Like, we were talking about that in Discord, how they got rid of all, like, the old Legends lore, the old lore, and that's just so much good shit was thrown away. Where are they? Oh my god, really? I am not fighting this horde of horseshit. Burned out on Star Wars after Han Solo. That's kind of also my case as well, is that I don't care that much anymore. I was never really a mega fan of Star Wars. I enjoy Star Wars, but I'm not, you know, foaming at the mouth, and nothing that they're offering has been enough to really entice me back. I've heard that Andor was very, very good, but I have not seen it yet. Oh, and it's more of those fucking punchy dudes. I hate them. They're everywhere. This is why this area is labeled bullshit on my minimap. Ooh. U.S. military station on some island with some natives. They got airdrops frequently, stuff like guitars. They shared with the natives, but one day they abandoned the military post and the natives built airplanes out of bamboo. Only the airdrops would return. Oh, God. Like the older games. Yes. Yes, the old games were great.
To victory.
I played Dark Forces? Was it Dark Forces? I streamed that years ago, yes. And it was my first time ever playing it. Oh, that game, that was so good. I was gonna see how this thing did against us if I didn't freeze it, but Goldleaf just cronked it on the head and it went unconscious, so we just ended that real fast. Oops. Alright, so the swamp is east.
I kill them all!
This fucking thing's a I am so tired of combat in this game. Anything you want to do, anything, you're going to have to sit through at least one slog of a fight. It is exhausting. And this is why specifically I'm designing the combat in Cudcrawler to be fucking fast and snappy. You're going to be fighting a million enemies a million times. Make it fast. This was apparently lost on Sirtek for this one. I can't blame him for this one, because combat was pretty slow in the previous games, too. Like, good lord. There's another Hogar. Nah, they're only 10,000 XP. Only 10,000 XP? Jesus. Yeah, I liked Dark Forces. I've played Dark Forces and I played Jedi Academy, and Jedi Academy was pretty good too. Of course, you have to play them with the realistic saber combat on though, so that you can just completely disembowel everything, because it makes it better. But still, it's a pretty good time. I don't really remember much out here. I think there were like mosquitoes, right? I assume that. That's where we're going. This map actually looks like something out of Neverwinter Nights. With all the straight-lined roads everywhere and everything.
Look, a creature!
Nope. Happy Ghost is tired of this game shit and he's ready to actually make progress. I just quick loaded, didn't I? Did I? I did. God damn it. Petulant rage. Having to run the roads again. Tried playing KOTOR, but after a huge amount of talking and reading. God damn it, Ela. I'm sorry that you have to read in your RPGs sometimes. Yeah, KOTOR and KOTOR 2, you kind of shoot yourself in the foot if you level before you have Jedi stuff. Past, like, early game, you want to level up a time or two, because otherwise you're just going to get face melted by everything. But yes, you can advance further in them in the Jedi classes than you would be otherwise. But that's purely for power gaming's reason. You do not need to worry that much about it. They're not particularly difficult games. Let's have you kill some stuff before the talking begins. Alas. You need your Icewind Dale for that. Love the gritty dungeon crawlers. You don't gel so well with the free movement. Really? Off the top of my head, the only free movement dungeon crawlers that I can say that I legitimately wholly enjoy are Might and Magic 6 and 7. Nothing else, and in even then, I would rather play the older Might and Magics. There's just something about the grid-based dungeon crawlers that gets the dungeon crawling. It just feels better.
Taken care of.
Although I guess Ultima Underworld's really fucking solid. I can't besmirch Ultima Underworld. But it's kind of its own thing. Hey, Kibitz, welcome back. Yeah, I vastly prefer grid-based to free movement. I'm not opposed to free movement, but I'll always take grid-based over it. Yeah, Ultima Underworld is an amazing game. The second one I'm not as huge a fan of, but the first one is really, really good. See, if random encounters were more of this and less here's 12 enemies that move really slow and poop ranged attacks at you, I'd be all for it. Because they come to me and I kill them. Alas, it's not what most of it is. Okay, Chunk with the dexterity and the vitality. And locks and traps. Faster is your biggest. Yeah, I mean, that's the other thing. It does feel good, like, scooting through a dungeon real quick because you know where you're going and just zipping around everywhere. Free movement invites stuff like platforming. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. I don't really have a counterpoint to that. That is very true. You get, like, the jumping and all of that in there, and that leads to its own levels of bullshit that you probably don't want to deal with. What does stealth even do? Bonus to armor class and making you virtually invisible in hand-to-hand combat. Oh, stealth's actually good in this. Fuck magic. We're a sneaky boy. Left Islands of the Caliph for that, but you got caught out of the other. Oh my god, yeah, the save breaking updates. When I let's played that, I specifically, like, told Steam not to update it because of the save breaking updates. That is, oh man, that is painful. I feel so bad for people's playthroughs who were fucked by that. Because that's a game that, having played it, I'm never going to play it again. I didn't have a bad time with it, but I have no desire whatsoever to return to it. And having to replay it would just utterly destroy any excitement I had towards it. Dung beetles. Where? Oh, I didn't even see those things. Okay. Sure. Jug. The final boss being walking around a queue. I'm not opposed. Not every final boss needs to be like some big thing. I don't think, like, for a game that had as much combat in it as Islands of the Caliph did, I don't think that was really the point, if that makes sense. It didn't feel wrong that they made the end of the game what it was. That having been said, it fucking came out of nowhere. And that kind of sucked. Okay, so are you guys angry at me now, or can I still come in and find the training transporter, disable it, and destroy their ship? Hi guys, we're here for your transporter. Wish it were a bit more explained. I agree with that, yeah, it was very much kind of like an overview of everything. It was very unique.
So. You have changed
but,
your mind.
Like I said, having finished it, I have no interest in going back. It's kind of like, God, what was that? That dungeon crawler, I streamed it ages ago and it was super trippy and brown. Aeons of the Sand or whatever? Aeons of Ruin? I don't know. And it, like, it's the same thing. I played through it once, and there's supposedly a bunch of different ways to go through it, but Aeon of the Sands, yeah. And there's a bunch of different paths to go through it, and it's, like, randomized each time you play it and based on your choices and stuff, but having finished it once, I have no desire to go back to it.
We have nothing.
Okay, dude, I need your transporter. Are we gonna have to do a fib? Or can I, like, wait a minute. Ow. Don't I have, like, one of their arms, or did I lose that? I think we still have it. Trang arm. Clearly I am a genius. The man's got a box. Picture shows a man holding a glowing object outside of a city gate. Scene reminds you of something you can't quite remember what. That's totally not Arnica. Who would guess? Yes, that game is very. That game has a color palette, and it reminds me of, like, old Amiga games, which is fine. But yes, it is a very brown game.
Tell me this: who you be, and then by chance your fortune see. Only one man shall I pass.
And
the name given is not thy last. Tell
is
me this.
Martin? Yeah, that's an easy one. Undead. I'll be back for you. Anastasia's a special. The two runs, regular one, unoptimized speedrun, just over 1 hour. Yeah, that's the other thing, is that game was short. I was actually surprised at how quick that was to run through, even like on a first run. I got through it in like a stream, which was not expected. And I mean, it wasn't bad. It played very unique compared to a lot of dungeon crawlers, but like, no reason really to go back. There wasn't enough to it. Filled with chemical symbols beyond your understanding. And the floor with these goop splorches on it, when we walk on it, we slide, which kind of sucks. Hello, Sadok Trang. Any desire for Dungeons of the Deep? They finally have remappable keys. I don't know. I don't know why you would want to remap any keys in that. They all seem pretty optimal from what I've seen. They're everything that I would expect from, you know, any dungeon crawler. A bird. Ooh, what is this? A fancy helmet. Brilliant helm, plus 20 intelligence. It's a shame that Rove's intelligence is capped, because I don't think this will let.
How exquisite.
The man is beyond smart. All right. Interesting. I'll be curious to see if that actually does anything. Snippet of the most helpful review in the last 30 days. If you like games like Dungeon Master, Legend of Grimrock, it is definitely worth giving this game a go. It takes a few hours of playing the game to really get into it and want to play more. I mean, I'm sure Ela usually remapped to the numpad. Oh man, you're going old school. You're going old school with that, Devlin. Hell yeah, I respect that. No, I'm mostly talking shit. Dungeons of the Deep is their baseline keybinds are fucked. Like, to open the menu, right? Instead of hitting escape to open your options menu, it's like page down or something. Ela played it, and oh boy, did he have a time. I'm gonna watch that playthrough tomorrow. It makes me happy when he's sad. And he was so frustrated by the end. Oh my god. He was, I understand that pain. Your left hand, oh, that makes sense. I totally get that. Especially if you're playing with like your mouse in your left hand. Yeah, absolutely. Go play Fall of the Dungeon Guardians. Oh man, yeah, if you play Fall of the Dungeon Guardians, the dev will be right there to help you every step of the way. Mouse and left and thumb pad and right. It's interesting. The only other left-handed person that I've seen do that, Devlin, is actually my mom. She was a lefty and would use the mouse in the left. All the other left-handed people that I know, they use the mouse with the right and just bitch. And I don't blame them. So it's cool. Now I know there's at least two of you out there. Take one of the books off the shelf, begin to read. The pages are packed with spidery handwriting. You can't make out much. It seems to be about the three focuses of the universe. Knowledge, life, and change. Okay. Kind of playing around here, some tips to try it on a lower difficulty. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, to their credit, the dev gives you, like, good difficulty options for that. You can make those games, like, legit easy, which I ended up doing by the end of Fall of the Dungeon Guardians, because holy fuck, I was done. So I can't be like, oh, it's a bad, poorly balanced game, because the dev basically lets you make the balance whatever you want within, you know, margins that are agreeable enough to me that I'm gonna be like, yeah, if I think something's broken, I can change it. Always done it back when you had an Amiga. Nice. Classic. Won't make the switches more visible. That's kind of shit, yeah. It's one thing to hide switches for secrety stuff, but anything that's, you know, expected progression, you want to be visible. Hello.
Stand back by order of the Trang Empire.
You and what empire?
Yes? Leave this area at once.
See, like, they're behaving reasonably. I come up here and they're like, stay back. I approach and they're like, fuck off. They don't immediately just attack. The Umpani, if you go somewhere they don't want you, they just immediately attack you. The Terang are level-headed.
This area is restricted.
Fucking three warnings before they attack us. Like, I almost feel bad for the violence I'm about to visit upon them. Obviously, we are not friends with the Terang, so I'm not going to even pretend to try to make friends with them.
Taken care of.
Let's go with... I assume at least some of you are spellcasters. Probably you.
With pleasure.
Hello. Damn.
Argelasta.
Hola podrida.
He's a biggin. All this talk of notepads reminds you of Romance of the Three Kingdoms. In Koei, where you play the game, you need to use the numpad for numbers and enter. I mean, yeah, like, the old Romance of the Three Kingdom games, those were like grand strategy games before grand strategy games were grand strategy games. I've seen Grimmoth play like a shitload of those things. And they're fascinating to watch, but I don't think I'd be able to keep up if I were playing it myself. Whipping rocks, sure.
Taken care of.
Feel bad for killing these guys, but they're not our friends, so. Gritter, you have a major project already here, wait until it's done. There are never enough gritters in the world, Devlin. Never enough dungeon crawlers, man. Like, I'm working on Cud Crawler, and even working on that, I would still love to make something that plays like Eye of the Beholder with the more real-time combat and stuff. But yeah, absolutely, gotta finish one thing first. That's why one of these days I want to take part in like a game jam that's, you know, a week or whatever. Try and get a week off of work and just make some crappy little Eye of the Beholder like thing that's much more limited in scope compared to Cud Crawler. Do something with that, could be fun. And it would give me an excuse to work with like proper pathfinding and stuff for enemies and whatnot, learn some stuff that I'm not too familiar with right now. Gleaming Sword, we used one of these for very a while. Well. Spellbooks, always exciting. Crushing, oh, got one for Ela. Speaking of finished projects, everyone and their friend is playing that new DOS adventure, the Crimson Diamond. Never heard of it. I mean, is it like an actual adventure game? Cause yeah, not really my jam. Can Ela learn Crush?
I would like to add this to my personal collection.
Yes, but no. Of course Ela would like to add Crushing to his collection. Paper Reading 4. That's the second one of these we've found. Where's the other one? Yeah, O. I don't know if that's a zero or an O, but it's like Colonel's bequest each. Oh my God! I need to let the dwarf know about that. She'll be crazy. What's it called? The Crimson Diamond. The Crimson Diamond. On Steam. Yeah, she fucking loves those games. Ichie text parser, yeah. Yep. That's absolutely right up her alley. Making cheese sauce yourself was a mistake. Well, yeah, absolutely, because then you can just make all of the cheese sauce. Text parser? Ah, text parsers aren't bad.
I saw something moving over there.
I think we found the teleporter.
An automatic Trang dispenser.
Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and fireball targets. Are you guys hostile? You are! This game gave me a present. A bunch of children to kill.
I'm on it.
This is the happiest I've been all night.
With pleasure.
Cinechar just blowing their mind. Oh man, I love video games. Oh, hey there, buddy. Welcome. I gotta turn off your thing. It's fucked. Sometimes you just gotta fireball some children. You all know how it is. And we haven't even started exploring this sneaky hidden place yet. We got buttons. Oh, this is... Oh, and we have wires. Ooh. I have things that I can fuck with. Where's the wires? I got these guys. No. Ah! Yes! Okay. And then it's... Four... And then zero. I mean, that's clearly not right. Or is this like... Oh, that's right. Yeah, somebody mentioned that the train teleport. This is their teleport out into the world. Okay, that it had multiple destinations. Okay. So I want to come to... This is the fucking Umpani base. Good lord. I want to go through to this one. Oh, hey.
Look about, critters.
Not the children. Eh, children are fine. Some of them are even on the wall right now. Ooh, another violin. What do we got? Freeze all! Well, I mean, you don't have to tell me twice. We got the single target, and now we've got the you just freeze everything nearby. Good God. I just want to get this open. So now we can come and go from this location as well. Come on, map. I know you can load. Now you got this, buddy. All right. Zoom in. Ring. Okay. Now I can just go back, and then yeah, so we'll be able to come and go from here. I might actually, it's almost tempting. What do we have? I don't know where that is. Or that. But I know these two. This one's got me curious. This, I wonder if that's out in where the killer crabs were. I'm not gonna worry about it right now. Can this terminal run Doom? Probably. So, I mean, this is... I require you to open, sir. Why do I have to wait for another one to come through? Because this is the... Yeah, the train transporter. Disable it and destroy the ship. I guess that's the next thing. Lord, I just realized we're, like, after 6 in the morning. What if I call it here shortly? I want to find their ship if I can. Oh. Where does this take me? Is this something interesting? Okay, I assume this is traps. Plate right there.
Let's show the enemy who's in
charge. Shit. It's the spirits of the damned. Yes. Boy, I bet that dart trap going off isn't gonna get obnoxious at all. Ghosts be rebels. I don't know. They're just rebels without a pulse.
Take this.
I'll wait. Okay. 46,000 XP for that. 46,000 XP for that. 46,000 experience points for that fight. It was trivial. I hate everything.
I am grateful.
Book of Portals. All right, well, there's another set portal spell. It's nice that they're giving us a bunch of them so that if you have a bunch of casters, you can have a bunch of people setting portals. Damn it, Ela. I assume this goes back down. Yeah. Back up, please. Thank you. Hey, ghost slaughter is no joke. Holy crap. I gotta know. Are these traps? No. Apparently, it's just a raised brick. Alright. That's a trap right there. How does it... What triggers it? Just walking? Yeah.
I have suffered an injury.
Shut up, Rove.
A fight like this is simple.
Okay, so it just dumps us into the moat. Alright, that's not... That's not worth exploring. Okay. This is like on the complete opposite side of the freaking Trang base. Good lord. What's this? North sector. Alright. Well, it didn't stand a ghost of a chance, you're damn right. On that note though, I think I'm going to go ahead and save, and I think I'm going to go ahead and call it here.